Good YouTube, what up, whoever's tuned in, thank you for tuning in for the random live again. Upper body pull focus routine, three exercises, minimalist style, two pull, one push. If you watched the previous upper body push focus routine that dropped this morning, you would have saw it was two push exercises, one pull. So the current split them on for this week, it just felt push pull legs. Upper, lower, and then I'm getting upper again right now. So it's the second upper day where it's pull focus, two pull, one push, starting with weighted pull-ups, testing my strength again. I'm going to teach you guys how to get stronger with the weighted pull-ups, right? I haven't touched this load in since April, so I don't even know if I'm going to be able to pull this much today. I got 95 pounds with me, and if I can't pull it, I'm going to show you guys methods how to get stronger with loads you can't use. Jay, you going to do pulls or no? All right, come on. We got a couple of the new Barm Natural members over here training at the park today. Here, wrap it
something like that. I was doing my push up, I was doing the way that they, and then somebody told me to do it somewhere else.
No, black across to here. There you go.
So I've been doing it.
And then just thread this one, put it through 135. This is going to be Jay's first time training weighted pulls. You guys might have seen him in the other video doing weighted dips on the last live stream. He hit 115 with me, or 125 actually.
This one, right?
Yeah, and you go that way. And you clip it to the left. That, yep, right there. There you go. Step off the platform and control it. Don't swing when you step off. The setup is key. You don't want to jump when you got weights on, so we got a little platform set up. Teaching you guys all the tools you need if you want to build strength with your weighted pulls right now. Step off 1 foot at a time so your hang's controlled. 1 foot off. Good, now drop in and pull. Another one, nice, go for three. Up, one more, hang. Big breath, pull. Nice, good shit, Jay, come straight down. No holds on top, you waste energy, good. That was the first time he ever did a weighted pull-up. 35 moved pretty smooth, so good shit. Yeah, just take the black. First, take that one off, and then the black. That's it. All right, Carlos, you're going to stay body weight right now. You got to clean your reps up. You're going to go for a set of five. Five like this. So I want him to look leg straight, no crossing, right? Here, pull down. Get that chin over every rep. Come to a full hang every rep.
Back.
Nah, you move that nice. Bro, you gotta think, you used to be heavier, so your body's used to moving that mass around, yeah. You know? Hang, 1 foot off at a time, control the drop. No, leg straight, don't cross them. Keep the core tight, pull. Chin over, right down, hang, full hang. Pull, full hang, pull. Let's go, two more, just like that. Pull, let's go, one more, just like that, Carlos. Hang, hang, let's go, up. Up, good, come down, perfect. It's those gloves, right? Those gloves fuck your grip up. I would just give you chalk, bro. Just take them shits off.
Felt good though.
Yeah, you want to get that full. If you're crossing your legs, you're losing your core. So keep the legs straight, everything tight. Glute squeezed, and pull straight up and down. I'm gonna go chalk up. Actually, I brought the chalk with me. So, pull focused upper body today. Again, sorry about the random live stream, but thank you for whoever's tuned in. All right, I'm gonna attempt a 95 pound pull today. Haven't touched this weight, like I said, since April. If I can't move it, I'm going to teach you guys one of the best methods you can utilize to get stronger with weight that you can't move.
How you know the right way?
No, but that's what I was doing in the beginning when I started. That's why I kept trying to pull my butt up. I used to pull my butt up.
95 pounds. I ain't gonna front. That surprised the shit out of me. That's a PR right now for me. 95 for almost 3 solid reps when I haven't even trained the way to pull up like that in a few months. So very pleased with that. 2 or 3 more sets, then we'll do some drop sets for some more volume. I'm gonna keep letting them get stronger. Let's go. Three good reps, Jay. All the way down. Don't hold on top. Just boom, 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 boom. That's it. Up and down.
I'm doing a 25, right?
35. There you go. Like a pro. Control the drop in. Always control the drop in. That's key. Don't let your body swing. You want to be under control. Full body tension. Let's go. There it is. Pull. Chin over. Down. All the way down. Down. Up. Up. Good shit. Down. Good money. Come on. Come on, Jay. Good shit. Go for another one. Pull. Clean. Good fucking work. That's what I'm talking about. Next set, go to the 35 and the 25 and try to get like one.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm getting stronger.
Aiden, how many push-ups do you think you could be able to do before you can do dips? I mean, you could be able to do push. If you could do 10 push-ups, you could start practicing dips. It's different biomechanics, right? One's horizontal pushing, one's vertical pushing. They both work the chest, and obviously dips are going to be harder because you're going to have more intensity, meaning your body weight's going to be just heavier on the dip because your feet are on the floor on a push-up. But if you could do 10, and if you could guarantee if you could do a set of 20 push-ups, you could definitely do a few dips. Let's get it, Carlos. Full lockout. Full lockout reps here. Good. Control. There you go. Put chalk on?
Nah.
You got it? I had it right here. Hold on. Let me bring another piece. Hold up. Oh, right here.
Where you look?
Just fucking rub that on. Just fucking smash that in your hand. There you go. Let's go. And look, he's just getting, we're teaching him how to build up his body weight strength right now. Full lockout, core tight. No crossing the legs. All the way down. All the way down. All the way down. Pull from there. There, down. Hang. Pull from there. Let's go. One more. Pull from there. Pull. There it is. Good shit. Remember, if you only drop into here, you're cheating yourself on the full range of motion. And the start is always the hardest part to initiate as you fatigue. So don't cheat yourself. Full lockout, full chin over. That's how you're going to keep getting the benefits of getting stronger with your body weight. And that translates right over to more weight when you're doing the weighted reps. There you go, Johnny. You already know. Getting copyrighted over here, but it's all good. All right, 95 again. So ideally, you want to take at least 3 minutes between these heavy sets. If you're working on strength and, you know, the sets are tough, you can see, like, the reps aren't easy. 95, I was getting, like I said, 2.5. Carlos, 5 are tough for him. Jay making the 3 weighted look pretty easy with the 35, so I'm going to bump him now to 50. He's going to go to 60. He's going to throw 25 on for his next set, and I want to see if we can get 1 to 3 next. Just smoother, right, Jay? Remember, no, try not to do that stop, too, because you pull and you stop. Just fucking pull straight and come straight down. You got to just get more in tune with that up and down motion. Let's go. Said deuce. Woo! Let's go. One more set heavy like this, then I'll drop the load, get more volume in. And I've been doing a lot of bodyweight reps. My workout 2 days ago, so the bodyweight birthday challenge, when we're hitting 5-10 every minute on the minute. I told you at the end of that video, that was gonna be a recovery-based workout for me, because even though it was such high volume, 175 pulls, 350 dips in 35 minutes, no set was too hard, no set was taking failure. That just helped facilitate a ton of blood and oxygen to the muscles, help them recover. And now 2 days later, I'm PR on weighted pulls. What do you think of that? Up. Straight down, money. That's it, one, that's it. That's it, just go for one, that was perfect. So now you do one more set of one, next set. We're back. Technical difficulties out here in Juniper Park. Yo, I've been having crazy bad service. I've been trying to bring you guys more lives too, so I know you enjoy them, so. Hopefully this stays on point for the rest of the workout right now. Let's go, Carlos. Another 5 right now. Don't cross the leg. Step off one foot, other foot meets it. Keep everything tight. Just keep the glutes squeezed, everything tight. Let's go, full lockout. Up, down, control the leg. Up, 2, down. All the way down. Pull. Legs together. Last one. Pull. Up. Good shit. Good money.
Damn, my shit hurts.
So now you're pulling right from full range all the way down, pulling up with strength. No kipping, none of that fucking jerking shit. Let's go.
Yeah, that'll go away.
What?
You said it hurts because of the...
Oh, the calluses? Yeah, bro, it's inevitable, bro. Look at that shit.
You gotta just get used to it.
I mean, gloves are good, but the gloves you had were no good. You wanna get like baseball gloves, batting gloves. Those are the best type of gloves to use.
Like leather?
Yep, okay. Batting gloves, exactly. Let's go, you guys got any more questions? Let me know in between my sets. I got one more set at 95. I wanna go into it fresh, so I'm not rushing into it. And our current weight, about 170 right now, 100. Maybe a little heavy, maybe 171. E, Big E, what up? We're hitting PRs out here, you're missing them. But yeah, I was on a little bit of a cut, and I was getting down to that 167. I was looking a little lean, then you know, I said, let's go increase the calories for about 10 days, and then back into a cut, right? That's how you keep the metabolism fresh, right? I was in a deficit for a while, especially, you know, since I have, you know, my whole overall energy expenditure decreased since the dog passed. So trying to manage it without having to drop calories too low. You go into a deficit for, if you're in a deficit for like 6 weeks, you could go a week, maybe 10 days back to maintenance calories, revamp the metabolism, and then go back into that deficit. You'll burn more fat. Let's go. Because the longer you're in a deficit, remember guys, the longer you're in a deficit, the hormones get messed up, right? Ghrelin, leptin, and once you know your body starts sending signals of starvation, it wants to hold on to fat at that point, right? So if you're too low calorie for too long, your body's gonna hit a point where it's gonna say, I'm not getting enough energy, let's hold on to all this energy, there's no reason to burn the fat. That's when you start to introduce a little more calories, tell your body I'm not starving, I got energy if I want it. You supply it a little bit of energy for about a week, and then back into that deficit, your body goes right back into fat loss mode even faster. Let's go. And like I said, those heavy reps, that high intensity set. And remember, for Carlos, when he's doing body weight, he's getting that stimulus because the reps are that hard. But when the reps are that hard, when I'm pulling 95 pounds and I'm struggling, and I'm really forcing for those reps, that's when you're straight type 2 muscle fibers. You're gonna build thick, dense muscle fibers. But remember, if you only train in that rep range, like I did for 7 months, training straight strength, what did I tell you? My aerobic capacity was down. I was super deconditioned. So it's better now to train in more rep ranges, unless you're training. If your goal is strength and you're competing, focus on that. But if you're looking for more aesthetic and be more well-rounded, you can focus on strength a little bit, and then you can hit more high reps, which is gonna help with that anaerobic endurance and your cardiovascular system. Now we'll drop the load. This is all of our third heavy set. Then we'll start dropping the load, hitting more volume. Chris, you gotta pay me my royalties for this video. I don't know, 1,000? I'm just kidding. I wish I got that paid per video 1,000.
Did I do something wrong?
You fucked it up, but you're fine. Just keep it tight. You just clipped the bolt on the same hook.
I think it's gonna be more
hair. Alright, so take it off. Yeah, you gotta undo
it. Fix it.
You did it backwards. Oh. Take the bolt off. That one's gotta go on the other side. No. So this one has gotta go there.
Oh, okay.
Oh, it's because you got the belt. No, just take the whole belt off. Just take the black off. You have it upside down, that's why. Flip it. There you go. Now black across. Hold up. This one's gotta be older, higher. So black first. And then there you go. And that's how you train strength. You gotta take long breaks. So if we were taking shorter breaks, there's no way we'd be able to get these reps out. Chest PR today, E. Good money. There you go.
Yeah, way better.
All right, Carlos, this set you... Oh, you're not... I'll tell you when you go. Let's go. Remember, hang, pull, one rep. Up and down. No struggling, no jerking. Pull. Up. Straight down. That's it. Money. Beautiful. All right, Carlos, watch. This is what I want you to do next set. I'll demonstrate right here so they can see. All right, so Carlos hit 3 sets of 5 body weight, full range of motion. I want him to hit now just one rep of holding chin over the bar where he's focusing on form. I want him to drop in, hang in, complete dead hang. When I say pull, he's going to pull just like this and hold right there, legs straight, toes pointed down, 10 seconds, then he's going to drop straight back down. Any beginners watching this video want to get better at pulls, follow this exact method that he's doing right now. Drop in, hang. Stop swinging. So start over. Come on, start over. Get that drop in cleaner. It's got, look, 1 foot off at a time. Keep the core tight. 1 foot off. Let all the weight drop. There you go. Hang. 3, 2, pull. Up. Chin over. Hold. Legs together. Hold it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Keep that line when you come down. 8, 9, straight down. Keep that line. Straight down. Down. Hang. 5, 4, 3, 2. Good money. Good shit. All right, we're gonna go into one more set, drop set. I'm gonna go
give me a song.
70 to, I'm gonna go 70 to 35 for one drop set. Maybe I'll throw a body weight into for a triple drop set. And that's it for the pull, the vertical pull work. I don't care, Chris, you play anything you want. Actually, I'm not even gonna go 70. That's gonna be too much intensity again. I already hit enough intensity with the 95. So I'm gonna go to 35 in body weight for one double drop set. Right into body weight. And any more than that would have probably been counterproductive. At 35, I went too close to failure, and you saw how much harder the body. I caught 15 with the 35, then only caught 6 with body weight, where I should have probably did 10 and 10. But you know, you always want to push yourself a little harder, but at least I knew smart enough not to do any more. Carlos got one more set of holds, and then he's done. I don't know where Jay went. But
he went over there resting.
One more set for Carlos, and then we got more, and then we're gonna go to a push. Clean drop, hands wider than that. There you go, one leg off, control it, core tight. There you go, pull. Straight up, combine, tight, tight. Hold it, right there, tight. 5, 4, 3, 2, come down, one line, don't lose that line. Look straight, don't move your neck. Hang. 5, 4, 3, 2. Good money. Good shit. Man. Yeah, we're done with that. Thank you.
Oh, shit.
All right, push work now. We're all gonna motivate to the wall. I'm gonna teach the guys how to work on handstand skills and strength. Parallettes. So, like I said, it's a pull-focused upper body routine. 2 pull exercises, 1 push. And like I said, minimalist training. Keep the reps and the sets tough. You don't got to do more. Just keep that consistency and the frequency of your training high. All right, boom. We're going to use the wall. Woo. So, deficit handstand push-ups today as the main push. And remember, that's a vertical pushing movement. The previous push workout you saw, we did weighted dips. No, we did handstand pushes and ring rows. I mean, ring push-ups, what am I saying? Can't think when you're exasperated. Handstand push-ups, deficit again. We did pull-ups, 70 pounds for 30 total reps. Then went back to the crib and hit roll. Today, like I said, I'm sitting for pull one push. This has been my main push as of late. Handstand push-ups, deficit handstand push-ups. And dips have been a supplementary exercise. So tomorrow will be a lower body day. And then the next day I'll train a dip-focused routine where I'm training heavy-weighted dips. That's how you keep the balance. And on that day, I'll probably keep the pull work very light. Throw in a little bit of light pull work. And that's it, guys. You can't, well, you can, because I did it for a while, right? But it can't be forever. I can't keep training strength, heavy-weighted pulls, heavy-weighted dips, heavy-weighted squats, all in one session, right? Three times a week. I was frying my nervous system, just leading myself to burnout. You do that leading up to a competition for a few months, then you transition off and you work in different rep ranges and different goals. So, like, if you guys are really trying to build up your body weight strength, I'm telling you, these deficit handstand push-ups are the best exercise for overall mass and strength development, because they're gonna give you the highest stimulation to fatigue ratio out of anything. You're not gonna be able to get a lot of reps in, you're gonna get a lot of stimulus, and you're really not gonna get, because it's only your body weight, right? You're not loading the nervous system up with a lot of load to really fry it. I'm gonna go grab my water quick. And just water and electrolytes. Remember, I told you guys, if you're training out in the heat and you're sweating a lot, make sure you're putting electrolytes in your water. That's the first thing that's gonna make your body cramp up or hit fatigue when you're training in the heat. All right, let's go, another set. Little tougher on the parallel bars compared to when I'm pressing off a flat surface. So typically when I'm doing the deficits, I have a few weight plates stacked up and I'm getting to press with my full palms on the floor, right? More surface area, stronger press like that, as opposed to having to press with a fist, right? Not one, there's no one better than the other. It's just preference. But for me, I'm stronger, and typically you will be stronger too, pressing with more surface area connected to the surface. Ooh. Hard sets. One more set of handstand pushes. Because like I said, I hit three set one and only two on the second set. So if I'm gonna keep having a drop off in reps, I'm gonna stop it and move on to the last pull exercise. Thank you.
You gotta take long breaks when the sets are tough like this. You know, sometimes that's the downfall of strength training, right? Sometimes you spend more time resting than you actually do putting in work. But if you wanna get stronger, you wanna get better at a movement, specifically I'm trying to get better at these deficit handstand pushes, I cannot go into the set fatigue. Going into the set fatigue is gonna be counterproductive. I'm gonna go nowhere. So I wanna make sure each set is quality reps. So you gotta go into it fresh. So another minute, try for one more set. What's up, Joe? How's it going?
All right.
Coming along.
Getting work done?
Waiting on. Oh, shit, Lewis. What's good, brother? Good. Yourself?
Good.
Thank you.
Keep it up, baby.
Thank you, brother. So getting into the last set. Let's try to get three. And you guys see, I did home at-home cupping last night. You guys want, go check out. I'm not sure if there's a permanent link in the video description, but I will put it. Recovery fund. They got the at-home cupping device is really effective. I'm telling you, I came in today, like you saw, PRs on the pull, so maybe it just loosened up all my muscles and everything. I was feeling extra fresh today. All right, another two, that's it. Three sets, deficit handstand pushes, and again, that just keeps the movement fresh, that keeps the nervous system learning that, okay, you're gonna continuously hit this movement, I gotta keep making sure I stay strong at it and get better and better at it. One more pull exercise, like I said, very minimal training, you don't need to do a lot, three exercises, two pull, one push, let's go. We got the rings to set up, so give me a minute. And I'll actually superset the next one. I'll superset pull, and I'll train negative handstands as a matter of fact, freestanding, just to keep that volume in. Rings, rows. Listen, you guys want a thicker back? Remember, you gotta do vertical and horizontal pulling movements. Get yourself a pair of rings, and the range of motion and the mind-muscle connection is gonna be like no other. I'm telling you, it's like doing cables in the gym, except you get better bang for your buck with body weight, and you can always load up the body weight to make it even harder. We're gonna do it with our feet up again to make the incline a little harder. All right, let's go, guys. I'm gonna give you guys a nice angle. Like I said, I'm gonna superset this. So, let's go. And that movement, you want to take it to muscular failure. Full range of motion, fully locking out, letting the scapula protract at the bottom, keeping the core tight, fully bringing the shoulder blades as far back as possible, retracting at the contraction, pausing, really focus on mind muscle connection here. With the weighted pull strength, last thing you want to do is focus on mind muscle connection. These type of movements, accessories, higher volume, keep the time under tension high, focus on squeezing and contracting the muscles. Told you, I'm gonna go right into a handstand. Negative. Yo, peace, Chris. And all I wanted there was just to control that rep down. Remember, you'll build more strength in the negative range of the movement, right? And you may not be able to press it up, but you could always control more load in the eccentric than you can in the positive, right? So if I wasn't able to pull those 95-pound pull-ups for reps, I was gonna set my bars up to the low bar, just like this. I was gonna set my parallettes up on this bar, but I'm gonna demonstrate here. So I would've literally just been able to hold with the 95, full negative, right? Let my body feel the load through the eccentric.